Jennifer, and today I'm going to be doing a DIY room decor for fall. Some of these may not seem like they're for fall because it can be like really changeable to each season. Is that even a word? I don't know. Anyway, I'm really excited for you guys to see this video, and don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you do enjoy it, and don't forget to send me a picture to Twitter or Instagram with the hashtag GenerationDIY if you try any of these out. Am I blurry? Or nah? Do you got a bae? Or nah? I feel like I'm blurry, dang it. I don't got a bae. That's okay! I just rhymed. Let's get started! So the first DIY is this magnetic board, and I think it's super cute. I've never had anything like this before, so it was really easy to make. And the first thing you will need is paint or spray paint like I have here, and some sort of metallic sheet or metal sheet of some sort. I'm using a lid from a cookie box, and I'm just spray painting that gold, and I'm just decorating by using some flower trim. So to hang it up, I just stuck two push pins in my wall, one for the top and one for the bottom, just so it wouldn't fall off. And I'm just decorating it and making it useful for myself. So I'm putting on a hook, some leaf decorations and magnets, and I can hang up my hair tie on that hook. And I also put a minion on there. Here comes a breakthrough! So the second DIY, you guys actually requested me to do it. I previously made the letter J, and you guys want to know how I made it, so I made the letter Z. So first you'll need some sort of box. I'm just using this ice cream cone box because that's what I had, a glue gun or a strong glue, some writing utensil, some scissors, and a ruler. So the first thing I did was I measured out what length I wanted my letter to be, and I wanted mine to be 24 centimeters, and I just drew a line across. Then I am basically just drawing out my letter, and it was 13 centimeters wide, and then for the sides of each letter it was 5 centimeters. I hope this is making sense. And you may notice that I kind of messed up, so later I just fixed that, and then this is what it turned out like. And since we are making a block letter, now I am just extending the sides, and those are going to be 4 centimeters, and that is the side piece of the block letter. I hope that makes sense. I'm just doing that right now so that I don't have to cut out another piece. Now I'm just cutting all of that out. So this is what it looks like. It kind of looks wonky, but I am going to be using the plain side because it is easier to paint on. But I don't know if you guys noticed, but I actually did it backwards, so later I will fix that. Now I am making the side strips, which are 4 centimeters wide, and I am just making a piece for every side. And this is what it's for if you guys didn't know already. And then I'm just going to be gluing the flaps that are already connected first, and then later I am just going to glue on my other side pieces that I just cut out. iMovie actually deleted a lot of my footage from this clip, so I'm sorry if it doesn't seem right, but hopefully you guys will understand what I'm doing. After I glue all of the pieces onto the sides, I realized that it was actually backwards, so I had to cut out another piece of the Z, and then I just glued that on top of what I already have so that all of the sides are covered, if that makes any sense. I hope that makes sense. If you guys don't understand, please ask me. And this is what turned out in the end. Now to decorate it, I'm using some contact paper, which is basically like sticker paper, some paint, some foam brushes, and I'm just starting out by painting the whole thing white so that the colors on top will pop. Now I'm just going to head over to my computer, and I'm just looking for pictures of leaves that I can use, and use whatever kinds of leaves your heart desires. So I'm just going to put that aside. I don't know the term. Basically, I'm just arranging it on the page how I would like to print it out, and then I'm just going to print it outonto my contact paper, and I'm just going to cut that all out. If you don't have contact paper, you can just print it onto regular paper and just stick the leaves on with tape. Now I'm just peeling off the backing of the leaves, and I'm just sticking it on wherever I want it to be. And mine is actually clear because it's supposed to be for textbooks to cover them, but you just want to press down so that the paint doesn't seep through the edges. And now I am just using fall colors to just dab onto the letter and make it look all colorful and fall-y. And now I am just peeling off the sticker to reveal the leaves, and if you need a touch up, you can use white paint. So this is how it turned out. I think it looks really cute. So next is this leaf bowl, and I just store all of my snacks in here because I am a food girl. So first I just took some fake leaves, some white glue, a balloon, and a container, and some water. So in my mind, this was going to be like a paper mache kind of bowl leaf thing, but it totally failed on me. So I just put some glue and a bit of water into my container, and then I blew up my balloon. After that, I took off the stems and veins of the leaf, and then I just dunked my leaf into the glue mixture, and I was hoping it would stick to the balloon, and when it was dried, it would make this like really cool bowl looking thing, but it totally backfired on me because it did not work. But anyway, we're gonna go to the way that I actually successfully made it, because as you can see here, it totally just failed on me. So I'm just taking the leaves off and letting them dry for a bit. Then I took this plastic bowl and I just spray painted that gold, and then I'm just gluing on my leaves to the sides, and I'm just wrapping that all around the bowl until it is all covered. And thinking back now, I probably should have bought more leaves, and these are from the dollar store, by the way, because it kind of looks empty and I wanted it to look more full. Anyway, I just covered the whole bowl with all of the fake leaves. After I am done gluing all my leaves on, I'm just placing that on my shelf and putting a bunch of snacks and food in there because gotta love food, guys. So the fourth DIY is this jar candle holder-ish thing. So I'm using some spray paint and a glass jar. So I'm just spray painting the bottom, mostly focusing on the bottom of the jar so that it looks like it's like fading upwards, you know what I mean? Or like downwards. This is what it turned out like anyway. And if you don't have spray paint, you can use a foam brush with some acrylic paint and just focus it mostly on the bottom again. Obviously, it doesn't look as good as the spray paint one, but it works. So now I'm just using an LED light, and I'm just putting the jar on top of it, and I just added this little jack-o'-lantern little thingy. I think it looks really cute. The last DIY is definitely the easiest. It's just this lined shelf to make your shelf a little bit more festive and colorful. So I just used some washi tape for my plain shelf. So the first thing, well, the only thing I did was I took some washi tape and I just lined my shelf with it, and you can use whatever kind of washi tape you want. Washi tape is so useful for so many things, and this is one of the things that you can do with it. Dancing in the mirror, singing in the shower. That is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also, I have made a second channel This is for like vlogs and random videos, and I've already posted my first video, so please go check out my second channel. I will link it down below. And the first video is a singing video. Oh my gosh, I am really nervous for you guys to hear because nobody's ever like, this is like the first time I've ever publicly, well, it's not really public, but you know what I mean. It's just not my thing. I'm just doing it for fun, but can you tell that I'm really awkward right now? Because I'm definitely feeling the awkwardness. That's about it. I will see you guys next time. Bye!